morning. The entrance hymn is number 318, Let Us Go to the Altar.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that
I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Have mercy.
Lord,
O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way, and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and highly to be praised. His greatness is unsearchable. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ, and death is gain. If I go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me, and I do not know which I shall choose. I am caught between the two. I long to depart this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. Only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Open our hearts, O Lord, to listen to the words of your Son. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with
you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off, and he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more, but each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones work only 1 hour, and you have made it equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord. Good morning, everyone. How are you? Good? Behaving yourselves? No. I usually go to confession twice a month, every 2 weeks. And I usually go to the same priest who has been my confessor for years and years. So he knows myself better than myself. So I go to the sacrament and I can share with you a couple of my sins, right? Those nice ones. So I go, "Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen." Say, Father, Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. It has been 2 weeks since my last confession. And Father always said, okay, let us ask the Holy Spirit to guide you, to tell me your sins. Father, it's basically copy and paste, period. Because it's almost the same. I said, but what is, you have to say your sins. It's the first one. In the first one, I can summarize all my sins. And which one is that? Father, I accuse myself that I have not loved God with all my heart, all my mind, all my life. I have not loved my God entirely. And you can summarize all my sins in just that idea. When you put yourself away from the Lord, temptations are stronger. When you put yourself away from the Lord, the devil comes to you and finds a beautiful place in which he can stay longer and longer. St. Peter, in his first reading, says, be careful, because the devil is like a roaring lion, always looking around to see who is ready to be eaten. In today's Holy Gospel, the Lord is reminding us that he's always around looking for his people. Some of us heard the voice of Jesus at a very early age. Some of us received the voice of Jesus in their 20s, 30s, 40s. Some of us heard the voice of Jesus in their 50s, in their 60s. And as the responsorial psalm says, the goodness of the Lord is eternal. Taste and see how good the Lord is. In today's Holy Gospel, the Lord is inviting us to always follow his voice. He's the owner of this vineyard, the church. He's the king of this beautiful kingdom on earth and in heaven. He's the one who comes to us every morning, every afternoon, every evening, even at night, or when we are sleeping. And the Lord says, come, come to me. Come and follow me. Come and you will not have doubts, but just follow me. And to hear the voice of Jesus means to go and do his holy will. And remember that the will of God is not difficult. The will of God is an easy task. Just love your God, love your neighbor as you love yourself. Just that. When you love your God, you understand it, that all of us are equal. We understand that God gives us so many blessings every day. We can walk, we can eat, we can smell, we can see, we can speak. What else do we need? In the gospel, the Lord says, come and work with me, come and work for me, and I will give you your payment. And what is the best payment we received? In the future, in the days to come, eternal life. In the present times, the Holy Eucharist. In our lives, peace, reconciliation, mercy, forgiveness. Come, the Lord says, and I will give you your daily wage. Lord, my payment is just to be with you. That is enough. Because when the Lord is present, life really changes. Who doesn't want to change among us? Who doesn't want a new life? Who doesn't want another beginning? Just love your God and love your neighbor as you love yourself. In the first reading, the prophet Isaiah said, seek the Lord while he might be found. Seek the Lord. Look for the Lord. Search for the Lord. Go around always fulfilling his holy will. The will of God is beautiful. It depends how you approach it. It depends how you love him. It depends on your decisions. Seek the Lord while he might be found. Call him while he's near. Because if we are getting closer and closer, yes, temptations will come to us. Blessed is the person who realizes that temptations are part of his or her life. because those temptations can also lead us to God. We never know how powerful the grace of God is until we face those temptations. Ask and you will receive. Knock and will be opened for you. Temptations, and if you know how to address them, they can lead you to God as well. Seek for the Lord. Look for the Lord. And if you remain faithful, you will receive your payment. Perhaps not down here, but always up there in heaven. Why not that when our moment arrives, to be in the presence of God and listen to those beautiful words, "Well done, my faithful servant, well done." That has to be that experience in heaven, to get into God's holy presence and stay with Him forever. My brothers, my sisters, seek for the Lord and all will be well. Seek for the Lord and things will be different. In the second reading, St. Paul says, "Brothers and sisters, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ, and death is a gain. In my body, through my actions, through my words, through my deeds, all of them has to show others all the beautiful things that God has done in myself. Love your God. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. But Lord, what about those who are sinners? Lord, how about those who just joined the church? They're holier than me." You relax. Take it easy. Enjoy the gift that God has given you. Pray for your neighbors. Pray for your friends. Pray for those who persecute you. Pray for those who humiliated you. Pray for those who did wrong to you. Just pray. But in the meantime, is that you and your God fight for your holiness, fight for your righteousness, fight for your eternal life, fight for your own gift, fight for your God and yourself. And never forget that the last will be first and the first will be last. There is nothing more beautiful in the presence of God than humility. The humbled, the prayers of the humble are always listened. The prayers of the humble are pure gold in the presence of God. Be humbled, remain humbled, because our word is always encouraging us to believe that we are better than others. Love your God, love your neighbor as you love yourself. And no, don't forget that God has made us as brothers and sisters, and all of us are the same in His presence. Good and bad, we are the children of God. But Lord, how can you be good with those who just came into your vineyard? I am not free to give what I want to all of you. Are you telling me what to do? The Lord will say it. Just take your daily wage and keep following me, because what I have prepared for you is beautiful, is worthy, and is enough for your salvation. My brothers, my sisters, seek the Lord now that we can. Seek the Lord now we have the chance to follow Him. And all together with the psalmist, why not to say those beautiful words, "Every day will I bless the Lord, and I will praise His name forever. Great is the Lord, and highly to be praised. His greatness is unsearchable. The Lord is near to all who call upon Him." Let us call the Lord. Let us call for His assistance, for His help, and always knowing that He's there just to help us, to guide us, and to consult us. At the end of every confession that I made, I always tell the priest, "Father, I know that I'm a sinner. I know that I will do this again. But when this is going to stop?" And he will say it 20 minutes after you die. In the meantime, remain whom you are. Love your God and love your neighbor as you love yourself. But never stop to seek the Lord in everything you do and everything you are. My brothers and my sisters, Who are we if we don't search for the will of God in our lives? That is our daily struggle. That is our daily fight. But at the end of this battle, we will receive that beautiful payment, the payment that only the faithful will enjoy, and that is eternal life. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand. In your books, page number 9, together let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten. True God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, has spoken to the prophets. Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Can I please ask you to sit for 1 minute, please? I forgot to introduce to you a new person in this congregation. So let me introduce Mr. Jonathan Castro. He is a 40-year seminarian at St. Joseph's Seminary. God willing, he will be ordained as a deacon this November 4th, in just a few weeks. So we have to pray for him, for his faithfulness and perseverance. No? Jonathan, welcome to Assumption Church. We are so happy to have you here this weekend. And something that we just found out, that after his diaconate ordination, when he becomes Deacon Jonathan, Assumption Church will become his church every weekend. So we are going to see him every Saturday and Sunday here until the date of his ordination. And hopefully, we can get him back as a priest next May. So, Jonathan, Deacon Jonathan, to be welcome to the church. We are so happy and you're rejoicing that you're here. Welcome back. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Father Sanchez, and thank you all for this warm welcome into this new community. And I look forward and I'm excited to work with you and serve you as a deacon in starting November, God willing. And as Father said, my name is Jonathan Castro. I'm a seminarian for the Archdiocese of New York in my fourth year of theology. So this is the last year of formation for the priesthood. And I come to you from St. Joseph Seminary in Yonkers. And permit me just to speak about the seminary for one moment. Before I do that, I was born and raised in Washington Heights and Inwood in Manhattan. I'm the oldest of three, and my parents came from Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic, and they have been here ever since they've arrived. And my home parish is Our Lady Queen of Martyrs, there in Washington Heights. St. Joseph Seminary is located in Yonkers, and it was established in 1896. And from that time up until the present, it has been serving the New York Archdiocese for 127 years in the capacity of formation of future priests and deacons. And your contribution to this second collection will help us continue that mission of formation. God knows we need priests and deacons to serve in our communities, especially in the time of need that we are. We are lacking priests. We're lacking young men who need to answer the Lord's call to this vocation. But your contribution will continue the mission of St. Joseph Seminary this weekend. Although this is my fourth year of theology, I have been a seminarian for 10 years, and I've started seminary back in college. I was 17 years old when I first started, and now 10 years later, I am soon going to give my life as a deacon, and you know, more importantly, as a priest this coming May. And just like myself, there are many others throughout the Archdiocese, but not only here, we serve communities in Brooklyn and Queens, Long Island, and Rockville Center. We have seminarians from New Jersey, Connecticut. We have a seminarian from Chicago. We have international seminarians and religious communities that you might know, like the Franciscans and the other communities that are around us. And so please pray for us as we continue to discern God's will for us. Please pray for us so that we can continue this journey of formation to the priesthood. And before I came here to Peekskill, I was assigned to Kennedy Catholic High School in Somers while working at St. Mary's Church in Katona. And just like there, among other assignments that I have been, I have never met as a community that has not benefited from St. Joseph Seminary. Because although we serve future priests and deacons, we also offer a master's program in theology. And the people who study theology, named men and women like you, are found in our Catholic schools and parishes, and they work in different capacities to educate our children. So after Mass, I will be available at the vestibule of the parish to greet you, to answer any questions, and to be welcomed into this community. So thank you again, Father Sanchez. Thank all of you for this time. God bless you, and please continue to pray for us.
Thank you, Janet. Please stand. God's ways are high above ours, yet our prayers are always heard.
For all who proclaim the gospel with their lives, especially teachers and missionaries, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who labor in the vineyards of peace, especially national leaders and elected representatives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who carry new life and those searching for a reason to enjoy it, that they may be comforted in the hope and joys life brings, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who strive to end disease and suffering, especially doctors and medical researchers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who gather at this table, especially the sorrowful and the lonely, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sick, Christopher Asobo, Andrea Emilia Burnaby, James Leon, and those listed in the bulletin, that the Lord will restore them to health, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those that have died in the peace of Christ, Elizabeth Ann Cardozano, Joseph Oliveri, Juan George Quinto Bertelesi, and especially for Francesco Di Ottavio and Brian Conklin Sr., that they be welcomed into the company of the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. In a few seconds of silence, let us present our own prayers and needs. Merciful Father, you are near to all who call on you. Hear our prayers and grant what the Spirit bids us ask. In the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
The second collection today is in support of St. Joseph Seminary.
The offertory hymn is number 623, Isaiah 49.
I will never forget you, my people. I have carved you on the for a woman, the child within her womb. Yet even if these forget, yes, even if these forget, I will never forget my home. I will never forget you, my people. I have carved you on the palm of my I will never forget you. I will not leave you orphan. I will never forget my own.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and good of all the Church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, joined with theirs, in one choir of exultant praise, as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you, everyone. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Jesus, Lamb of God,
gates of the world, have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep and mine know me. The communion hymn is number 344, God's Holy Gifts. Holy gifts for God's holy people, come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving, know in your heart that he died for you. May the blood of Christ be food for our souls and bring us to everlasting life. God's holy gifts for God's holy people, come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and know in your heart that he died for you. May the blood of the Lord protect us from harm and mark us as God.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for 1 minute. Two quick announcements before the final blessing. Number one, just remember or remind others that this coming Wednesday, our CCD program begins officially. So everybody, all the kids have to come this Wednesday for classes. If your child or the children are from first to fourth grade, classes begins at 4 o'clock here in the church. And if the kid is in between fifth and eighth grade, classes begin at 7 p.m. also here in the church. It is official. We registered 827 students this year, more than ever. So still looking for some volunteers or perhaps yourself who can come and help us, not only to teach the kids, but also to control the kids, you know. Sometimes they can be hyper, so we need a lot of helpers, a lot of hands. So please, if you can make it happen, give us a hand this year. And second, and this is a nice thing, a lot of the requests that we get from churches, groups, from other places, are based on money. But this week, through Mrs. Kathy Bishop, who just came back from the Holy Land, we received a beautiful letter, a request letter, from this group of sisters, Franciscan sisters from Bethlehem in Palestine. These sisters run a school for kids with special needs. There are about 30 kids who are either blind, cannot walk, children who cannot speak, and all of them has been rejected by their families and pushed away. So the sisters went to their homes, brought them into their convent, and that convent became the children's home. So the sisters also run a school for these kids with special needs. The sisters are asking for our help. They don't ask for money. They only ask for one thing. Say, Father, is this possible that perhaps you and your church can help us with some school supplies? Because we are pushed away from Israel, we don't have pencils, we don't have pens, we don't have notebooks, we don't have crayons. It is possible that perhaps you and your people can help us with some school supplies. And I pass the message to you. It is possible that we can help those kids with some school supplies. Next weekend, our CCD students will be receiving all those items in the back of the church after each Mass. Because on October 4th, we have a group from New York going to the Holy Land. So I ask these people if they can take those items to the sisters, and they say, yes, Father, we would love to. So we have until next Sunday to collect whatever we can collect in regard to the school supplies and ship them to the sisters and the kids in Bethlehem. So I think that that's beautiful. I think it's a beautiful way to show how much we pray and we love those kids. But remember, since they have been pushed away from their families, the sisters became their family. And thank you for everything, seriously. Besides our problems and difficulties in life, there are people who have bigger problems and bigger struggles. And perhaps this is the moment to show them and to prove them that there is still goodness and goodwill in our world, in our lives. So next Sunday, if you can help those kids with some school supplies, such as pens, pencils, notebooks, crayons. So please help us out. Thank you, everyone. And I'm sorry for always asking. But, you know, sometimes it's good to share with others what we have received from the Lord. Thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful week. May this week be filled with blessings and graces from heaven itself. Amen. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel,
defend us in battle.
Be our defense against the wickedness and the snares of the devil.
May God
rebuke it, we humbly pray.
And to thou, O Prince of the heavenly host,
by all the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all of the evil spirits who prowl throughout the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Have a blessed Sunday, everyone.
The recessional hymn is number 385, With One Voice. Take the word and go out to every land. Shine the light of Christ for all to see. May the lives of those we touch sing praise to God above. Let us sing. We'll sing. Voice, we'll pass the word along. With one voice, bring justice to the world and reach.